Patrick Tyler. Name of my company is Tyler Financial Services Group. Well, when I got out of the service, I started a business. It was did some electrical contracting work for a while. Opened a store and started selling TV stereos, CB radios at the time. We expanded that into some furniture and some other items. Did service on those products. Kind of drifted from that, and long while that was in effect, got into the advertising business with a small newsletter that we produced daily in a small town that was a tourist-oriented town. That kind of grew into a printing business. It just kind of took off from there. We ended up selling both of those businesses after about 7 or 8 years. And, bought a radio station for a short time. We kept that for about 2 years, me and another fellow. And then we had an offer and we sold that.
How did you get involved in the financial services industry?
And I was at the American Legion one day and met a fellow who was the finance officer of the American Legion. He was also the chief controller for the county, Washington County Social Services people. And we got talking and found out we both had small tax businesses, so we decided to kind of become a partner and become partners, which we did. We grew that business quite a bit, from tax business to a monthly accounting business. And from there, we just kept growing. And we did that for about 4 years. During that time, I got my securities license and started doing that because it's a real natural fit for accountants in the security. Well, it grew really, really fast from back in the early 80s up through the mid-90s, which time my wife and I decided to move to Myrtle Beach. We had been down here for about 2 weeks, and she came down with viral meningitis and ran an extremely high fever for 3 days and lost all of her memory. So before we even got the office open in Myrtle Beach, we were pretty much limited to what we could do. When I got her back home after several weeks, I pretty much became a caregiver. That caused me to have to rethink what we were going to do with the business. I then decided to go ahead and drop a lot of clients that were required a lot of work, which generated a lot of money. But I kept the business going, but I kept it going in a much smaller manner. We went from probably doing a net of $350,000-$400,000 a year down to a net of probably $50,000 a year. And at that time, as time went on, she got better. And in 2009, I decided to move back out of the house and start growing it again, which we did. We first opened it in a business center down in North Myrtle Beach. We outgrew our single office there in about 3 months. Rented a suite in there, a suite of two offices, much larger offices. And by the end of our lease, we had well outgrown that, so we moved over in this facility. We've been here ever since.
You also touched on that you do internships for Coastal?
Right. We do them both undergrad and graduate. We do both accounting and financial analyst positions. The internships we have here are more of we give you, assign you work that you should be capable of doing, and we help you when you have problems. But we expect you to be able to do the work because that's what you have to do once you graduate. In the MBA program, we pretty much assign them work and say, here it is, do it. And because they should know how. They're in their last semester of their MBA by then. If they don't know how by then, I'm not going to put it out there. But they always do. When Coastal sends us students, they're really very good students.